Today we're going to be looking at my body transformation over the years, my entire life in fact. I've been gymming now for 12 years, I'm 32 years old, and I've done it all completely naturally. No PEDs, no fat burners, no pre-workouts, literally nothing, no supplements other than whey protein. I'd just like to say there is a million people out there with better physiques than me, so thank you for watching if you do watch it all. So it seems only right showing me flexing in the garden, about 4 years old there. I was really into football at this age. As you can see, Leeds United fan from Leeds in fact. Here I am at high school. As you can see, naturally at this kind of age, I'm not slim, I'm not fat, but definitely got like a little bit of thickness to me. On the left is James Power, who goes on to be a very significant person within this story. So in 2005, I saw this documentary about parkour called Jump Britain on television, Channel 4. This documentary literally changed my life forever. Not because I was particularly great at it or anything, but as you can see here at the bottom left, I soon found out that photography was my calling and I have ever since made a living out of it. So at this point, I'm doing parkour all day, every day. I've gone from a little bit thick at high school to, as you can see, I've got some triceps going on and I've also got abs kind of going on. On the left is Dambo. I don't think a lot of people know that me and Danny met through parkour, but there we go. So around here, my life started changing more and more as I just started college, learnt to drive, started smoking a lot of weed, start going uptown, also got a girlfriend, got a job at Domino's as a delivery driver, which didn't help the physique either, because after every shift you get a free large, or used to, whether they still do that, I don't know, but I was eating a lot of Domino's, smoking a lot of bud, drinking a lot of beer, eating a lot of pizza. Here I am, probably at my worst, can I call it worst? I'm very happy, like I look happy and I was happy, but I'm also pretty fucking not healthy, man. I'm boozing, I don't think I'm doing any exercise at this point. Parkour's long gone, I'm still following it, but I'm not training ever. I'm just small and skinny, pretty druggy, smoking loads, going to loads of different house parties, lads holidays, Dambo, James Power in these again, keep getting blackout drunk. I just love boozing and drinks that I would never be drinking nowadays. Look at that, I'm literally pre-drinking with Frosty Jacks and profiteroles. That's an insane combo. I must have realized that at this point I needed to change my life, which is why I then started the gym. Just had my first day at the gym, nice session and struggling to lift 5 kilograms. 27th of April, 2011, almost 12 years ago. Here I am, photo with a dumbbell. Quite an outrageous photo, I'm not gonna lie, I look an absolute twerp. As far as I'm aware, this is the first ever photo of me with a protein shake. The hair is a joke, I promise you, I don't know why I've got, I just look disgusting, but there we are, I got a protein shake. First photo, as far as I'm aware, of healthy eating. I've got a side of almonds on there, that's cottage cheese on crackers. Still ripping bongs, still drinking excessively. Got my first ever progress file on my phone here. This is secret calculator. So at this time, my girlfriend, her family lived at the other side of the world. She would go visit them for 3 to 6 months a year. We'd been arguing a little bit and I was just like, fuck it, when she comes back, I wanna be shredded. So I did my first ever PT, 8-week transformation. My first time ever doing anything like that, you know, it was a big learning curve. A lot's moved on since then. Research that you can find easily for yourself online and whatnot, but I think a lot of the techniques and the stuff that I was doing was quite a lot of nonsense, if I'm honest with you. Like, if I go back to the almonds photo, I was eating a handful of almonds every 2 hours just to keep my metabolism ticking over, apparently. Almonds are high in calories, man, so to be eating like a handful of almonds every 2 hours, I am telling you that would not be the way to get a great physique. I mean, it's obviously worked to some extent. Anyway, so my ex-girlfriend is back now. We are doing normal relationship stuff, like eating in bed all the time. Then I broke my hand, flew off a Tarzan rope. The kind of thing that you see on You've Been Framed. Flew off it, broke my hand, mate, gutted. After quite a long time off, 10 weeks off in fact, I knew that I needed to do something about it, so I started going to cardio classes at my old high school. There I am on the right. A few months later, here I am with Tom Zanetti in I don't know where I am, it doesn't even matter where I am, but as you can see, my arms are looking a little bit wham. Slowly getting there. I must have been really into doing my arms at this point, because as you can see, I play this video, I'm just fucking doing arms all the time by the looks of it. But I gotta say, like, my physique is definitely coming on here. I remember being really proud of this video. 6 out of 7 days this week at the gym, definitely overtraining, if I'm honest with you. Don't need to be training that often, although I do still sometimes do that, I'm not gonna lie, but I definitely have more rest days nowadays.
I've dieted flawlessly, might I add, for 5 days, and I've just weighed myself and I've gained 3/4 of a pound.
Funny, I'm going on about eating flawlessly, but at the same time, at this point in my life, I was addicted to edibles. I say addicted now, addiction's a strong word, but I was pretty keen on edibles. Like, you see this full selection box here, how nice all them things look, and they all get you mega stoned, so it's kind of like a win-win, do you know what I mean? Like, you're eating really nice treats and at the same time you're getting baked. I couldn't stop eating them, I was having them loads, but I was also making some healthy choices. My mate here, he's having a pint, I'm having a protein shake. This is me skinny dipping on a date. Funny date, cold date. This is like September, I think. As you can see, definitely putting a little bit of size on, hitting a front dub, not something that I do often, so there you go. I am overtraining. To be doing 14 days consecutive training is completely unnecessary. And I just said previously that I'm eating flawlessly, and look at that ice cream sundae. What am I lying for? Why am I telling you that I'm eating flawlessly when I'm just obviously not? This is a finisher that I was really keen on for a while whenever I trained my shoulders. So you do 10 press ups, then you get up and you do 10 of these, and then you get down, you do 9 press ups, then you get up, you do 9 of them. As you can see, my rig is really starting to come along. And I remember looking at this photo thinking, fucking hell, I have never seen myself looking like this before. So something's working. I must be dieting quite well. I said flawlessly previously, I doubt it, but there's some sort of diet going on there, do you know what I mean? Let's keep it going. This is another finisher that I love to do when I'm training my chest. I almost regret that I didn't know how to like diet really well at this point, because I feel like if I could have really cut hard when I was in that shape there, could have been my best ever, do you know what I mean? Like, if I could have just hit that cut then, I'd love to have seen what the results could have been. Anyway, so here I am doing some ab workouts. As you can see, my core's getting stronger, a bit of width in my lats. Body looks like it's just all coming together. Tom Zanetti's birthday in Ibiza. Honestly, this was one of the first photos in my life where it wasn't like optimal lighting, I weren't pumped, I weren't flexing or anything. It was one of the first photos where like I woke up the next morning, I looked at it and I was like, I have more or less got my dream physique. I remember just like thinking, fucking hell, like, I've worked for quite a long time at trying to look something like this, and for the first time I look like what I want to look like. So at this point, after Ibiza, James Power is now fighting professionally and has set up his own gym, Powerhouse. There's me, Dambo, Smithson, and James on the left. At this point, I got into kickboxing. It's been 3 years since. This was like the missing piece for me getting into the shape that I'm in nowadays, because I was always missing that cardio element to what I was doing. Like, I've been gymming for years, just pushing weights and whatever, but I was never doing something to work off them extra calories, you know what I mean? Like, really, when I go to the gym, I might be burning 400 calories, which is not really that many, like, in the grand scheme of things. So I would really recommend to anybody that they can try find that extra activity as well as pushing weights. There's something about kickboxing that, like, I can do it for an hour, I can burn off a lot of calories, and I'll be gutted that the session's over. I really, really enjoy it. So finding that has been, honestly, it's been a blessing, and James has played a significant role in the shape that I'm in nowadays. Thank you, James. That was me in America doing my first backflip in ages. Then I came back, I had a gym session just before the world locked down.
You must stay at home. One form of exercise a day, for example, a run, walk, or cycle.
The weather was great at the start of the first lockdown, so I would spend every morning going out for a walk, doing a bit of exercise. I'd get home, play Call of Duty. I would then go out for a run. For the first time in my life, got into running, so much so that I spent 150 quid maybe on these trainers. I loved them, I was proper proud of these trainers. Here we go, 5K PB. This was my best time that I got, 21 minutes, 16 seconds. Never got sub 20. Tried my hardest. I really wanted to get it, but I don't think I could ever get a sub 25K. Even that extra 1 minute 16 seconds to knock off, I don't think I could have ever done it. This was my biggest run that I ever did, just short of 20 kilometers in 1 hour 36. To say I'd never been a runner in my life, I was pretty happy with the pace that I was doing these runs. Hammer a bit more Call of Duty, and then in between rounds on Warzone, I would do what I would call boxing bags workouts. As you can see, my physique is really coming along here, if I may say so.
What's that way? It's like fucking 5 kilo, that book.
I never thought this day had come, but gyms are now fucking reopened. And A-Star are doing a midnight march. Look at this, what I'm about to walk into. Let's fucking go.
Yeah, savage, bro.
Training with TZ at this point.
Don't be fucking dinting the whip, big dopey fuck.
Something about this video and photo that just, I just find it hilarious, man. It's just a crazy little photo. That's Tom's next door neighbour, Clive. That G's followed by standing on that car with him there just proper makes me laugh.
Do a backflip off a car? Backflip off a car? Backflip off a car?
Broken foot.
Whether I broke my foot, I'm not so sure, but it looked like this for a number of weeks. That was from kickboxing. I'm now in Dubai for my 30th birthday. This is still during lockdown, managed to get over to Dubai. I think this was back and buys, in fact, in the hotel gym. Looking pretty diced, if I may say so. Pretty happy with that physique. And then I came back and we went into another lockdown. During this second round of lockdown, started watching loads of fitness YouTubers, Joe Delaney mostly. More plates, more dates, a lot, and Leeds' very own Mike Thurston. I also stumbled across this podcast, which changed my life genuinely forever.
Practice does not make perfect. Practice with a night of sleep is what makes perfect, because you come back the next day and you're 20 to 30% better in terms of your skilled performance than where you were at the end of your practice session the day before.
Wow.
I mean, sleep is the greatest legal performance enhancing drug that most people are probably neglecting in sport.
Wow. And not just for your physical performance, but actually skill learning.
That's right. Skill learning, memory, and then also, you know, downstairs in the body, all of the recuperative benefits.
I prioritize sleep so much more now after listening to that podcast. It will blow your mind, I promise you. Go listen to that podcast if you've not listened to it already. So this next lockdown, it was during the winter. Me and my mate Murray put our money together and we got this lockup, and it was some of the most memorable training sessions I've had ever. I loved it. We called it the Cube.
Yeah, so
you
have like a national
record.
Damn, bro!
The cold one today!
Yeah, chillin', mate.
Like we can discuss living in Spain, but when you really do it big, nobody celebrates off. 92% healed, still living. See what happens when I get to deep things. When you really fall in love, till you blow and explode, starts feeling like your hometown and never stops shrinking.
A few months pass and gyms are on the verge of opening again. So here's a photo of me with the Cube on the last day. Look at it, what a setup. And now I'm back in pure gym. My lats have got some width on them. Doing a holding L-sit, hanging L-sit, is that what you call that? I'm not so sure.
Oh, toes are shaking.
There I am, flexing my abs in pure. I think my abs look pretty decent on that. This is me looking very vascular, the sunbeds. This is me in pure gym in Leeds. This photo might be my best physique ever, potentially. I'm lacking on my upper chest, definitely, but other than that,
peanut butter and apple and a J.
Peanut butter, apple and a J.
So at this point, Dambo's got his own gym. A huge moment, especially for him, obviously. But for both of us, amazing to see him doing so well. I'm now jumping in between Danny's gym, my usual Pure gym, and A-Star Muscle and Fitness. Here I am in one of their vests and hitting some triceps. Of course, Powerhouse, doing kickboxing still with James Power, getting the cardio in. This is a 5-week transformation that I did 15th of June, 2021. There's quite a long caption to go with that if you would care to have a read. I don't know if you do care, but if you do, you can find that on my Instagram. I'd like to say that is a decent 5-week transformation. I gave it a good bit of welly. I am eating a lot, or drinking rather, a lot of protein powder. I'm eating a lot of protein yogurts. I'm 3 months with no protein powder at the moment. Here I am with James, leveling up at kickboxing. So this is me in Santorini. This could be my favorite physique that I ever had, to be honest with you. This is like early summer 2021. Could be my best look, I think. Yeah, very happy with that. Brushing my teeth. And then here we are at Kavu Tagu. Rigged up, nice lighting. And then I came back and I started a 20-week bulk. My first ever strategic bulk. I mean, I might have been bulking accidentally for years before, but this time, like, I was doing it for a reason. Look at this set, or this rep, rather. Absolutely all in. As you can see, I'm proper trying to work on my upper chest during this bulk. I was working on my legs as well, but I've not really got any video footage of my legs. Something about legs. They've got a little bit of catching up to do. They never look skinny. My legs never look skinny, I wouldn't say. Just naturally, like, they're quite thick legs. But I think I've got a good top half, and I would say the legs don't quite match up. So give me a little bit of time. This year, my legs are going to come through, and it's going to be more balanced. During this bulk as well, all my ab workouts, pretty much everything I was doing was with 20 and 25 plates. I was getting strong on my core. This is Christmas Day. My brother got me one of them surprise footy kit things where you don't know what you're getting. I got Austria. I've gained 2 stone here. And then 6 days later, the worst timing ever.
New Year's Eve, 2021. A&E.
I ended up at A&E. I ruptured the tendons in my elbow. So going into 2022, I had 8 weeks where I didn't train at all, and then I went on holidays where I was wearing clothes in environments where I wouldn't usually wear clothes just because I hated my physique. I went to America straight after Thailand, where I was there for a month and I was eating whatever I wanted. I was in America on holiday, do you know what I mean? So I weren't wanting to hold back. Skip forward a few months and I'm slowly getting back where I was. As you can see, here I am at Powerhouse, looking slightly rigged up. A couple more months pass. I'm now in Danny's gym, which has got a lot more equipment, looking well furnished. Danny looking wham. Me in the mirror. And there we go. That's the session that brings us to the latest physique shot. Yeah. Is that my best physique that I've ever had? Potentially, some parts of it, yes. I have since had a hair transplant, so I had to have a month off. And then after that, it was Christmas. Enjoy Christmas for what it was. And then after that, I did a week away. So it was quite a long time where I was gymming where I could, but it was definitely a bit of downtime. But since getting back, I've been back for a couple of weeks now. I'm now doing PTs with Dambo, early morning PTs. I've sorted my sleeping pattern out. And for the first time in my life, I'm carb cycling. I'm not drunk once yet this year. I'm 6 months sober of weed. I kind of thought I need to drop weed, otherwise I'm never just gonna go for it with YouTube. It's funny, in my first couple of episodes, you can see that I'm talking about weed. I'm smoking weed on camera and stuff because I was smoking daily at that point. I've been smoking daily loads leading up to it for months, let's say even years potentially. And I just thought, like, I was filming all this footage for YouTube and just not putting it together and not dropping it. And I was like, stop smoking, maybe you'll sort it out. And I did. Subscribe if you want to hear me touch on them subjects in the future. If you want to keep up with how my physique's going to go from here on out, it would be much appreciated. I hope you got something from this video. Thank you very much. Till next time. See you in a bit.